Did you know 42,000 new toxins are entering our environment every year? And most of them are air toxins. Now, what researchers have found, most of the time it goes in the blood, the body, the organs, the cells. But what has come out recently, it now shows that those air pollutants are going in your brain. And I'm gonna show you on this Saturday strategy what you can do about it and something you can make to purify not only your body, but your brain. Let's go. So I don't know if you remember this, but a couple years ago, I was in China and my heart really went out to all the people in Beijing, in Shanghai, and even in parts of Hong Kong where there was pollutants. I couldn't even see 100 yards in front of me from my hotel room. And when I got back to the States, my digestion was messed up, I developed a cough, it was absolutely miserable. And I thought about the people in San Diego, I thought about the people in China and the rest of the world. And I realized that because of these air pollutants, people were slowly dying inside from these terrible toxins being in the air. So being the superfood nerd that I am, and I geek out about the weirdest stuff, I decided to do some research on this. And what I found out was absolutely crazy. Experts have known for years that pollution is harmful, not only in the body, but the brain, the lungs, the skin, and the heart. And because these recent studies have been done, I want to talk about how pollution has been done to the brain and what we can do about it. I don't know about you, but keeping my brain healthy, vibrant, young is extremely important to me. So let me ask you this. How much pollution do you actually think you're breathing in? I bet these stats are about to freak you out. Are you ready for this? Here's the facts. Statistics say that the average American breathes in 2 gallons of air per minute, which means you breathe in around 3,400 gallons every single day. So depending on where you live, how much time you spend waiting in traffic, how much time you spend walking on roadways determines the type of air and the quality of air that you breathe in every single day. Actually, researchers at Lancaster University in the UK found that in these magnetic particles from air pollution, those magnetic chemicals that float through the air actually get lodged in human brains. And not only is that nasty air hurting your lungs and heart, but it's lodging itself inside your brain. Our air is something that, as a culture, we can work on cleaning up and bring awareness to. I'm gonna teach you some easy ways to detoxify your body from the nasty pollution. So how can you detox from this air pollution? I'm gonna give you a bunch of tips in the blog, but to start off, here are some important ones that you're gonna wanna know. Number one, wheatgrass. I absolutely love wheatgrass. It's incredible at cleansing your blood. It also helps get rid of those pollutants from the air that are in your body. It helps press them out. So check out this recipe and get started on cleansing your body and your brain today. Here's my Purify wheatgrass juice recipe. The ingredients are simple. A handful of wheatgrass, a half a cup of fresh parsley, half a lemon, 2 cucumbers, handful of spinach leaves, so hopefully you enjoyed this recipe. Now I know this video may scare you a little bit and you're gonna go outside and you're gonna think that you wanna be the bubble boy from that movie and get this big thing around you. Simply not like that. Take a deep breath. And know that no matter what you breathe in, Mother Nature has the answer. Mother Nature has the key. You're completely protected. You're fine just who you are. But know that through nutrition and these things that we share in this video, you're gonna be set apart from the rest of the population. And it's our duty, it's our job, it's us being present in life and attracting this type of information into our experience that really is special. And I look at you right now through this video as one of those special people that gets this message and really understands it and wants to improve the consciousness of humanity. So share this with a friend. I'm Drew Cannoli. As always, remember, we're in this together, and I'll see you next week.